I mean, part of this inflationary problem is because we put too much money into the economy. There's way too much government spending, and that's why we have inflation. So that's a large part of that.
That is,
it's just basic economics.
And that secondly, is not basic economics. We had this thing called a pandemic. We had a supply chain crisis. Okay. And oh, by the way, there's a war in Ukraine.
It played a role. It's played
so
a role.
So to act like the only reason we have problems now is because people got a little bit of money in their bank account is just not honest. And you,
Krystal Ball of the show Breaking Points, went on Bill Maher's Real Time show, and the topic of inflation came up, and Krystal Ball pushed back on the notion that the high inflation that we're experiencing right now is solely a result of government spending, or mostly the result of government spending. David Dole of the Rational National broke all this down. Let's check it out.
Somehow nobody gets upset about the rich people who got tons of money and tons of support, way more than working class people did.
Sure,
but
they
do. My God, people were able to feed their kids and they had a little bit of money in their bank accounts. It was the worst thing in the world.
Krystal Ball, who is the co-host of Breaking Points and Krystal Kyle and Friends, was on Real Time with Bill Maher and did a fantastic job. Absolutely fantastic. So it is really hard to pierce that Bill Maher elite bubble, but Krystal Ball managed to do it, and her commentary on some of these issues, just great to have someone there actually educate a large audience of largely unaware people. So I have three clips to share with you. Let's just get to the first one. Is Joe Biden too far left?
Here's my question about Joe Biden for you two. Has he pandered to the far left, A, too much, B, too little, not at all? Because AOC would say not at all.
Well, if you look,
other people would say he panders way too much to the far left.
If you look at the trajectory of his presidency, at the beginning of his presidency, he did some of the things that myself as a person on the left would like him to see. He passes the COVID relief bill, and lo and behold, he had very high approval ratings.
You're not always on the left.
Then, I am on the left. I'm a Bernie Sanders leftist.
There's the populist economic left, and then there's the woke left. And these are two separate.
In any case, let's talk about what he's actually done. So in the beginning of the administration, he passes that. Very high approval rating, doing extraordinarily well. When he puts out the left agenda in the Build Back Better and then it fails and he stops delivering for the American people, that's when he falls off.
What do you mean by the left agenda in the Build Back Better?
Well, there's universal pre-K.
Put meat on that.
It's not everything that I would want.
Right.
No Medicare for all. There's no Green New Deal. But you had universal pre-K. You had affordable child care. You had elder care. You had an expansion of Medicare. You had things that would have delivered for the American people. That falls apart. Partly because of Manchin, Sinema, Parliament, all of that. That falls apart. And since now the American people are feeling incredible pain with inflation and gas prices and unable to put food on the table and put gas in the car, and he's basically seeded the ground and said, there's not much I can do. I just hope the Fed gets this under control. Yeah, the approval ratings have fallen off a cliff. That has nothing to do with the left. I wish the left had more power. In fact, I think the left is the only part of the political spectrum that has offered anything to deal with inflation, gas prices, and the current economic situation that doesn't just involve, hey, let's trigger a recession and kill people's wages.
Incredible. Incredible. And I have two more clips that arguably are even better. But before I get there, just quickly on this clip. First of all, on Bill Maher's question. Really? Really? You have to ask, is Biden placating the far left too much? Based on what? What has he done for the far left? What are you talking about? So Bill Maher is, if you have watched the show recently, and I have barely because it is terrible, but I've seen clips, I see what he focuses on. He is very focused on the far left woke mob. That's what he's concerned about. So, you know, saying Latinx instead of saying Latino or Latino, that's very offensive to Bill Maher, as opposed to, I don't know, low wages, as opposed to the climate crisis, as opposed to the cost of healthcare. What's really important is Latinx. Oh, that people don't want Latinx. But this is like, if you want to say, I don't know, has Biden even weighed in on these culture war issues? Because I don't think he even has. So in what realm, in what reality is Biden too far left or trying to, you know, placate the far left? What are you talking about? But anyways, let's get to the next clip. This is on a debate over inflation and who actually got money during the pandemic.
Well, I mean, part of this inflationary problem is because we put too much money into the economy. There's way too much government spending, and that's why we have inflation. So that's a large part of that.
That is,
it's just basic economics.
And that is secondly, not basic economics. We had this thing called a pandemic. We had a supply chain crisis. Okay. And oh, yeah, by the way, well, there's a war in Ukraine.
It played a role. It's played
so
a role.
So to act like the only reason we have problems now is because people got a little bit of money in their bank account is just not honest.
And you, a little bit of money, they got more than we spent in World War II. So you don't act like
hold
the
on, hold on.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Hold on.
Don't act like, you said don't act. Don't act like we had to react to the pandemic exactly the way we did. We had to spend $6 trillion.
Okay, but how about the trillions that the Federal Reserve shot at?
One thing that Bill Maher probably won't point out is that the United States' response to the pandemic in terms of the money that people were given was actually less per capita than what a lot of other first world countries did. There were people in some countries that were getting payments for months, whereas in the United States, it was just two payments. So the United States actually did less than what a lot of other countries did. Bill Maher is not going to point that out.
But at Wall Street, for some reason, people don't get upset about that.
What'd you say?
Fueled the trillions of dollars the Federal Reserve shot at Wall Street to backstop the stock market and the bond market. No one gets upset about that, that was a massive
factor in inflation. I don't know what you're talking about. What do you mean shot at Wall Street? What are we talking about?
We're talking about buying assets, buying stocks, buying bonds, buying treasury bills so that they expand the balance sheet. This is during the crisis, the coronavirus crisis. When the stock market crashed, that is what the Fed did. They went into action. They shot
trillions
of dollars.
But the stock market didn't crash during COVID.
Now it's crashing. It's crashing now.
It crashed and the Fed came in and backstopped it. That's what happened.
It crashed and we never heard about it?
No, it crashed. Go back and look at it.
It
fell off a cliff.
When?
The Treasury bond market stopped functioning and the Fed took extraordinary action it's never taken in history.
I don't remember that.
Somehow no one gets upset.
It made the first week of the pandemic.
Somehow nobody gets upset about the rich people who got tons of money and tons of support, way more than working class people did.
Sure
but
they
oh
do.
My God, people were able to feed their kids and they had a little bit of money in their bank accounts. It was the worst thing in the world.
No.
That is one small part of the inflation story. And is, by the way, not the only thing that we can deal with to get out of this mess. Well,
oh my goodness. Again, incredible job here by Krystal Ball. And really, the other two cannot keep up. Oftentimes when there is someone who is more on the left on this show, it can be hard to get, a word in edgewise because this is basically you got to talk over each other. But Krystal Ball here just again and again gets her points out, is able to succinctly, put forward this actual knowledge that the other two are lacking. How does Bill Maher not remember that there was a stock market crash? Like, this is your job, dude. You forgot about this? Now, look, I get a lot has happened since then. Even I, for a second, was like, crash. Oh, yeah, the crash. Like, that happened. So I'll go over a bit of that in a second here. But and I'll get to a third clip that's also great. But just Krystal Ball, again, fantastic job. And, I've disagreed with her at times in terms of maybe certain issues that she's focused on or certain topics she hasn't focused on as much that I would focus more on. But regardless, we have different, approaches to these things. That's fine. That's normal. It's okay to have differing views or differing emphasis on certain topics. But here, throughout this episode, did a fantastic job getting her points out and really educating the audience. Now,
and the media narrative, including on shows like Real Time with Bill Maher, throughout the last few years, starting with the pandemic, was all about government spending led to inflation and nothing about, as Krystal Ball said here, big businesses were bailed out with, and even some smaller businesses with loans that they never had to pay back. They artificially propped up the stock market. Corporations dramatically increased prices well after the supply chain issues were through. The media and people like Bill Maher never talk about that.
So I'm going to go over a bit of this because this is just amazing that these people, Bill Maher and James Kirchick, the other guy there, just are completely out to lunch. From American Prospector, which, by the way, great piece. I'll read a bit more from it in a second here. But David Dayan, if you want to know what the hell happened here in terms of the crash and what the Fed did, read David Dayan's piece. In fact, just follow David Dayan and the American Prospect in general. Fantastic outlet here. But his headline, how the Fed bailed out the investor class without spending a cent. Just announcing $4.5 trillion in future spending to support securities markets was enough to keep owners of capital protected from the downsides of the coronavirus. So we'll get to more on this shortly here, but this is what Krystal Ball is referring to here. And so let me just quickly, global stock market post biggest falls since 2008 crisis. So that was March 9th, 2020 from The Guardian. This year, Black Thursday, Wall Street stocks plunged 10% in worst one-day loss in 32 years. The key takeaways from this crash. So the 2020 stock market crash began just as the World Health Organization declared COVID-19 an official pandemic. The Dow Jones fell nearly 3,000 points on March 16th, 2020, was the largest single-day drop in U.S. stock market history. Unlike some previous crashes, however, the market rebounded quickly and set new records in late 2020 and early 2021. So just to be clear here, here is the Dow Jones, 10 biggest one-day point losses in history. The top seven are all 2020, one after another. Like, come on, Bill Maher, where were you? What's going on here? And here it is in graph form just to give you, you know, a
Bill Maher wasn't covering that because it doesn't fit the agenda.
Bigger indication or more context in terms of how big this drop was. They bailed out these massive corporations, bailed out Wall Street, and what did people get? A single check from the American Rescue Plan and Bill Maher saying, oh, they got all this money. The elite bubble that he is in, Bill Maher often talks about bubbles, how the right's in a bubble, how the far left woke mob, they're in a bubble. Bill Maher is in a bubble. He is in the elite bubble. To not realize that people are struggling and that a single check is not going to save their lives is remarkable to me. But it shows you really how disconnected he has become. He's always been disconnected, but this is even more so than, you know, previously. But let me get to the last clip here, which is over gas prices.
Gas prices.
And this is a great point here by David Dole. And it's no different than back when the financial crisis, 2007, 2008, around that time happened. And there were trillions of dollars given out to bailout companies. And nobody blinked in terms of the government. But if it's anything that's to actually help regular people, then that has to be analyzed and pored over. And the questions from people like Bill Maher and others in the mainstream media is, how do you pay for it? The same thing with all the wars. There's never any real discussion about how it's going to be paid for, because that's something that benefits big corporations and not just regular people.
We can largely attribute to an administration that's been waging war on the fossil fuel industry.
That's ridiculous.
And now
they drilled
demand
more than ever. I mean,
that's a talking
US
point. That's
U.S. production.
No.
Okay, U.S. production is up.
Well,
it will be at record levels next year.
Okay, well,
the fossil fuel companies themselves are flush with cash, but will not invest in new drilling because they would rather give it to their shareholders.
Okay, all right,
that's the truth of what's
happening. Well, here's the truth. I mean, I just read it today. In 2020, Biden said no more drilling on federal lands, no more.
Look, no Keystone Pipeline.
Yeah, no.
Oh,
okay, and I'm not
for
and
not
also antagonizing Saudi Arabia.
Oh,
now he's going back to Saudi Arabia hat in hand.
Wait. Let us finish what we're
all
saying.
All right.
And then you can shut up.
Well, antagonizing the Saudis with his Iran deal policy, and now he's going back to them hat in hand to get them to increase their production.
But I bet you're in favor of the Russian oil ban.
Yeah,
Saudis are great
Russia
humanitarians.
Russia is raping a country right now.
Yeah, and the
Saudi
Saudis
Arabia
are amazing humanitarians.
No, I didn't say that. I didn't say that. They're our allies.
Right. And by the way, the only issue with oil is not just supply and demand, because as I was just saying, we actually have a fairly significant amount of supply. It isn't at, you know, extraordinarily low levels if you look at the recent past. We don't have an extraordinary amount of demand. We're not even back to pre-pandemic levels. You do have a massive amount of Wall Street speculation that is also causing an increase in gas prices.
Yeah.
So again, this is what I'm saying, that the
gouging.
Only people who are talking about
and
that,
some people
and there's a lot of price gouging.
There's a lot of gouging.
So you asked
it can
whether...
always depend on them to gouge.
You asked whether Biden is not...
So at least you have Bill Maher admitting that there is gouging going on. That's a major, major aspect of the inflation that we're dealing with right now, is just corporations simply gouging people.
pandering to the left enough for too much or whatever. The left are the only ones talking about those issues, about the fact that you have monopolies that have jacked up prices far above what they need to because they can, because they can use the excuse of inflation. And CEOs are bragging on earnings calls about how they've lifted prices and gouged consumers, and we're not doing anything about it.
Oh, my God. I'm so impressed. I really am. This was such a fantastic job. Maybe one of the best appearances from any guest I've seen on Bill Maher, just in terms of her ability to get these points out, to just put these people in their place. Multiple times there, she shut down James Kirchick and just exposed his garbage on monopolies, on oil production, on his lack of principles when it comes to the Saudis versus the Russians. And then by the end, he just had nothing to say. Because what can he say? What Krystal Ball is detailing there is exactly right. It's objective reality.
So great analysis here from David Dole from The Rational National. And also, as he pointed out, a really great job by Krystal Ball to go on Bill Maher's show and really push back on these corporate mainstream media narratives. Bill Maher, most of the time, is going to side with the establishment, the side with the rich and the powerful and the corporations. And you don't have a lot of instances of someone like Krystal Ball actually pointing out the lies there. And this went viral as a result. So what do you think? Do you agree with Krystal Ball? Do you think she was right in pushing back on Bill Maher? Do you agree with Bill Maher? Do you think the corporations weren't to blame for this, that it was all government spending is the reason why we have such high inflation? If you like content like this, make sure to subscribe to my channel. It helps me to grow. Also, give me a like and comment on this video. I'd like to hear what you have to say, and I'll see you in the next one.